If you're thinking of using Bubble or already using it and not very happy with the performance, check out this alternative. It's called Momen. For full disclosure, yes, this video is sponsored by them. But I'm not doing this just because they're paying me. It's because they're legit and paying me. Link is in the description. You don't have to listen to me. You can go there and check it out yourself right now. But keep watching if you want to know why I don't just think it's comparable to Bubble. I think it's better. Some no-code app builders sell themselves as easy to use. Some sell themselves as powerful. Nowadays, when I get asked to review the latter, if it's mobile-focused, I compare it to Flutterflow. And if it's web-focused, I compare it to Bubble. I believe these two are what most think of when they think highly capable no-code app builders. I understand why. They are far from perfect, but they are the closest to a one-size-fits-all answer. So to me, if you want to make a new no-code app builder, and sell it as a robust and customizable option, you need to ask why people would use it in a world with Bubble and Flutterflow. Because that's what your target market will ask. For starters, you have to be as good. Whatever I can build on Bubble or Flutterflow, I would better be able to build it on your platform. On top of that, you have to do something better. And no bullshit like, oh, we've got more intuitive UI. Give us something solid. And Momen said, okay, here are three solid reasons why you should use us over Bubble. And that's what I'll be sharing. But first, let's recap Bubble's strengths and weaknesses. Bubble, strengths. For a no-code app builder, it's very powerful and flexible. It's a full-stack platform, so it can be your front and backend. It's got a huge community, so troubleshooting is easier. These strengths make Bubble very compelling if you want a high-quality no-code MVP. Weaknesses, it uses a proprietary code base, so you're locked in. It charges based on workload units, which can get pricey. And when making this video, I realized Bubble has a weakness common among all legacy systems. It's less capable of adapting to new technologies. It sounds crazy to call Bubble a legacy system, but they've been around since 2012. Assuming it's just an MVP, vendor lock-in isn't the end of the world, but depending on what type of app you need, the workload units can add up. So for Momen to even be considered, it's got to have Bubble's strengths and address its weaknesses. Let's see. Number one, full stack. This is the easiest one to address. Both Bubble and Momen are full stack no-code app builders with a focus on web apps. Yes, I know Bubble does native mobile apps now, but web apps are still their number one. Some people prefer to split their front and back ends. That's how you get combinations like WeWeb and Xano, or Flutterflow and Firebase. But for simplicity and convenience, you can't beat an integrated front and back end builder, which both Bubble and Momen offer. Number two, powerful and flexible. Going into Momen's app editor, the layout reminds me more of Flutterflow than Bubble actually. It definitely feels less polished than Bubble's, but all the essentials of customizing your apps are there. The ability to create APIs, access your database, define actions, or use granular input fields for the components. Oh, one thing that really hurts Momen for now is the lack of reusable components. Whether you do no code or custom code, being able to reuse a component you've customized is a lifesaver. So that's not good. But the Momen team says they're actively working on it and it should be added later this year. So it's just a problem right now. Or you could say it's a problem at the moment. Either way, you won't get this level of customization in something like Good Barber or Glide. So yeah, if you can build it on Bubble, you can probably build it on Momen. Number three, community. Momen was started in 2019, so they've been around for 7 years. But Bubble has been around since 2012, 7 years longer. No contest here, both have their own forum, which even look the same. But Bubble's forum is a full-blown community. It's Bubble users helping other Bubble users, which is what a forum is for. Meanwhile, Momen has a fair share of threads, but it's more like a customer support system where their team troubleshoots issues for users. So compared to Bubble's three strengths, Momen also lets you build powerful, robust web apps. Can also be your one and only full-stack platform, but it doesn't have Bubble's community. To their credit, the Momen team does answer all user questions on their forum, and that's why you want a community in the first place. So I won't hold it that much against them, especially considering where they outperform Bubble. Number one, AI agent integration. Momen has an AI agent builder inside it. When you open the editor, head over to the AI tab and you can see Momen has made it very easy to choose an AI model, define its function, and fine-tune it with prompts. It's a very convenient way to add an AI chatbot to your app or site, which I can imagine will be the norm in the future. But if you are real deep down the AI rabbit hole, Momen lets you do way more, just as easily. If you've used one of those drag and drop AI agent builders where you customize your own workflows, you get those capabilities with Momen too. Crucially, you can use the standard OpenAI model or choose Claude, Grok, or Gemini based on your use case. And if you are really hardcore, you can use your own locally trained DeepSeek model. And whatever model you choose, Momen lets you further enhance it with retrieval augmented generation, or RAG, by connecting it to specific data sources like a website or folder. Structured output, where you can train the agent to create organized answers that can interact with your app directly. So it can help with filling in a form, updating a dashboard, or triggering an action. Tool usage, where you can connect agents to other agents and tools like your calendar or email to enhance its decision-making and automate tasks. Here's an example of a scheduling app with two AI agents built in using Momen's AI Agent Builder. Here's another example of a mental health assistant with 7 agents. I don't know of any other tools that lets you do that. Bubble certainly doesn't. To be fair, you can build an AI agent with another tool and connect it to your Bubble app via API, but it's an extra step. And it's not an easy extra step. You're connecting two tools that don't really know each other. It's a bit like WordPress, which was never built with all its current capabilities in mind. So a lot of WordPress is just tapped on and never quite as convenient or efficient as, say, Webflow, which came later and was built with all these fancy animations and stuff. I don't think Momen planned for this. I think they got lucky. They're young enough that they can properly integrate an AI agent builder into their stack. And when I sent this script draft for review, they didn't make any changes. Because if your app builder could do it, why wouldn't you integrate it? AI agents are increasingly commonplace, and I can see a not so distant future where having agents in your app is just an industry standard. And to not have one, you better have a good reason. So if you want to build fancy web apps and fancy AI agents, and you want to easily connect them so your AI agents can help run your app, do yourself a favor, check out Momen. Number 2, better pricing for higher usage. Both Bubble and Momen charge based on how much their servers have to work for your app. However, and I apologize, I've tried to simplify this as much as I can. They don't calculate usage the same way and end up with very different final figures. Bubble uses workload units to measure how much processing an app needs. Every time your app does something, fetch data, make an API call, use a plugin, uses up workload units. Momen charges based on request per second, RPS, meaning how many users are interacting with the app at the same time. It also considers resource usage like storage and how much data is sent out. If your app is small or new, you probably won't notice much difference. Across the board, Bubble and Momen have very comparable pricing plans. However, once an app becomes more popular with lots of users and activity, as workload units usage increases and so do requests per second for Momen, Bubble is likely to be more expensive. A large-scale app will likely end up needing a dedicated Bubble instance under their enterprise plan, which will run you anywhere from $2,000 a month to $3,500 a month, far higher than Momen's $120 per month per dedicated instance. Number 3, better performance. Momen claims that where Bubble's processing capacity is around 100 rows per second, Momen's is around 5,000. Here's a video of their team doing a side-by-side comparison of how long it takes to update 10,000 rows. Bubble takes over a minute while Momen takes less than a second. Now imagine this multiplied by every other interaction on your app. In theory, an app on Momen can process 50 times as much data as the same app on Bubble. It can support 50 times the usage and 50 times the users. Of course, how many apps really need to process 5,000 rows of data every second? Well, maybe an app with a proper AI agent built into it. Also, I think you will agree it's better to have something and not need it than to need something and not have it when it comes at no extra cost. It's not like Momen is saying we are 50 times faster, so we'll charge 50 times more than Bubble. Plus, if you check around, you will find complaints about slow load times for Bubble apps. Then you add in the fact that adding an AI agent will probably incur heavy usage, and apps with heavier usage cost less to run on Momen than Bubble. And it's a pretty compelling combo. So after all that, let's recap and talk about why choose Momen. If you're considering Bubble in the first place, you probably want a proper web app, and you're okay with vendor lock-in. As far as I can see, Momen is bubble, but more cost-effective and powerful for apps with complex and heavy usage. It out-bubbles Bubble. It's not perfect. Its community is nowhere near as strong, and don't underestimate the power of having thousands of other people to help you troubleshoot. Momen's also not as polished, which I accept as a purely subjective opinion. But look at where it stands out. AI agent iteration, better pricing for higher usage, potentially better performance. Those matter way more than a community, especially since the Momen team seems quite good at replying to user issues. So if I was already going to use Bubble, I'll at the very least check out Momen. Both lock you in, so you might as well get locked in the better and more scalable trap. That's right, Momen is my sponsor and I just called them a trap. I don't care, I get paid in once. Also, it's not Momen or Bubble, it's no code. I made a video where I heroically exposed the truth of no code. No code as a whole is a trap. I break down what to expect and why the best use case is still making MVPs before transitioning to custom code once your revenue makes sense. So watch that video, but if you found this video informative, leave a like and subscribe if you haven't. I take on a 5% sponsorship request only if I see something actually useful and not just another clone of a successful product. But I get it, sponsorships always make people wonder. So if you like when I bring you useful tool, let me know with a thumbs up. If you don't, type middle finger in the comments. Thanks for watching, and let's see if you have the right idea about no-code app development.